Welcome to the Weekly Wind On, a recap of the biggest news, latest reviews, and best advice from MCN. Head to motorcyclenews.com for full details of the stories mentioned, and then have your say in the comments section. This week, KTM pulled the covers off a new track-only sports bike called the RC8C. The bike uses the parallel twin engine from the firm's 890 Duke R, wrapped in a hand-built steel frame and carbon Kevlar bodywork. You also get Dymag wheels with Pirelli Diablo Superbike slicks and race electronics. But all this comes at a price, and each of the 100 limited edition bikes will cost £31,000 plus extra for race or track day packages to be confirmed. Earlier this year, Yamaha announced a new baby retro called the XSR125 that combined grown-up styling with learner-legal power. We got our hands on one this week, and it didn't disappoint, earning 4 out of 5 stars overall. At £4,450, the new bike is a brilliant introduction to motorcycling for new riders, but would also make a trendy commuter for an experienced rider trundling in and out of the city. And sticking with new 125s, we also got to ride the new Honda Grom, which was updated this year with a Euro 5 engine, 5-speed gearbox, and improved dash. There's no denying the new version is great fun, but unfortunately, its pit bike-esque dimensions and top speed of just under 60 miles per hour mean you'll feel vulnerable if you venture too far out of town. There was big news from the Triumph factory this week, as they announced that they will be developing and building competition motocross and enduro bikes with factory teams competing at the highest level. And judging by the fact they've brought Ricky Carmichael and Ivan Cervantes, who have a combined total of over 17 world titles in off-road disciplines on board, they're not messing around. And finally, French boutique bike builders DAB have unveiled a new learner-legal electric bike called the Concept E. The prototype has chic modern supermoto styling and uses a carbon chassis and top draw suspension and brake components. There's no word yet on price, but if the level of finish is anything to go by, it's unlikely to be cheap. Thanks for watching the Weekly Wind On. Join us next week for another episode, hit like and subscribe, and make sure you don't miss it.